BLASTOMUSSA are large polyp stony corals which grow a hard calcium skeleton with soft, fleshy polyps that can range widely in color and size. They typically originate from the Indo-Pacific, specifically places like Fiji, Tonga, the Solomon Islands, and Australia's Great Barrier Reef. There are several different subspecies of BLASTOMUSSA, or BLASTOs as we call them in the hobby. The most commonly kept variety is definitely the BLASTOMUSSA welsi, probably followed by the BLASTOMUSSA merletti, which have much smaller polyp heads. But there are as many as four other known subspecies, with the latest one, BLASTOMUSSA angulara, only being discovered as late as February 2021. As far as lighting and flow requirements go, BLASTOs are a great choice for a beginner LPS. They prefer low to medium light with low to medium flow, generally best kept in the lower third portion of the aquarium to accommodate those needs. Ideal tank parameters for BLASTOs are right in line with the typical mixed reef, maintain stable alkalinity, and keep calcium above 400 to ensure mineral availability for skeletal growth. When it comes to feeding, BLASTOMUSSA are able to get the necessary energy to survive from photosynthesis alone, but they will benefit from target feeding as well, especially when it comes to how fast they grow. Many reefers report increased growth rates when regularly feeding a meaty phytoplankton-based diet. Like most LPS corals, enriched mysis shrimp make a good choice here. 1 to 2 target feedings per week should be more than sufficient for this species. Here's a tip: when feeding your corals, you may want to aid them by fending off would-be thieves from stealing their lunch. Some inverts like cleaner shrimp are notorious for this type of behavior. BLASTOMUSSA grow individual heads that can be fragged using a wet bandsaw or bone cutters like most other LPS corals. Single head frags will usually grow new polyps around the base and will become round mini colonies relatively quickly with regular feedings. When the frag grows into a colony, single or multiple heads can be fragged off, which allows for great options as far as shaping the mother colony over time. In conclusion, BLASTOMUSSA is a great choice for just about any reefer. They're a great example of how color morph variability in the hobby has increased tremendously in the last decade. When I started in the hobby over 15 years ago, the only Blasto Welsi color we got was a bright red. Don't get me wrong, it was beautiful. It was about as deep red as they could come, similar red to what you see on like typical Cynarina nowadays. They were gorgeous, but they all looked the same for the most part. Now we have so many different color morphs spanning basically the entire color spectrum. It's great to see rare new variations come into the trade and be successfully aquacultured and passed around the reefing community.